Hi students, all of you, good morning and good afternoon. Welcome to my class. In the last class, we are discussing the concept of photoelectric effect. The mathematical form of photoelectric effect is written as capital E is equal to E naught plus KE. And according to Planck's quantum theory, capital E is equal to, that is the energy emitted by a hot body or energy absorbed by a hot body is equal to H nu. So if capital E is equal to H nu, then we can write E naught is equal to H nu naught plus KE. So this is another form of photoelectric effect in terms of frequencies. Here nu is there, here nu naught is there. Now, what is meant by nu naught means? Can anybody text what is meant by nu naught? Nu naught is called as threshold frequency. Threshold frequency means the minimum amount of frequency required to eject an electron from the surface of the metal is called as threshold frequency. And all of you know, nu is equal to C by lambda. So when nu is equal to C by lambda, instead of nu, suppose if I am taking nu naught, nu naught means threshold frequency of a metal is equal to C by lambda naught. Lambda naught means threshold wavelength. Once again, lambda naught means threshold wavelength. So by using these formulas, today we are going to solve two problems. If time permits, I will solve two problems. Yes, I'm going to share the screen to all of you regarding the problem. Please purchase the NCERT textbook. As soon as possible. As on the screen, you are seeing a problem 2.8. Please note down in your running notes, problem number 2.8. On the screen, you can see very, very important problem, important model. Please note down that one. And after noting down, please read the concepts. What are the data given in the problem? What we have to calculate? So what is the data given in the problem? When electromagnetic radiation of wavelength 300 nanometers falls on the surface of sodium. Sodium is a metal, that is the first A group element, that is the alkali metal. Once again, sodium is the first A group metal, that is known as alkali metal. First A group metals are ready to lose the electrons when they are going to be striked with some sufficient frequency of radiation. But in this problem, frequency is not given. What is given? Wavelength is given. How much wavelength? 300 nanometers of wavelength is going to fall on the surface of sodium metal. Electrons are emitted, means electrons are going to be ejected with a kinetic energy of 1.68 into 10 to the power of 5 joules mole inverse, means joules per mole, per mole. Per mole means here, how many electrons are going to be ejected? 1 mole of electrons are going to be ejected. The 1 mole of electrons ejected are having kinetic energy 1.68 into 10 to the power of 5 joules. When it is happening, when the sodium metal is going to be striked with a wavelength of 300 nanometers, electrons, 1 mole of electrons are going to be ejected. And the ejected electrons are having kinetic energy 1.68 into 10 to the power of 5 joules. So kinetic energy of ejected electrons is given. KE is given. Yes, all of you seeing which value is given here? KE is given. Kinetic energy of ejected electrons of 1 mole of electrons is given. And 300 nanometers is given. 300 nanometers means nanometers is indicating wavelength. Wavelength. So with the help of wavelength, what we can calculate? What we can calculate? We can calculate capital E value. That is the total energy of radiation striking on the surface of the metal. Once again, capital E means the total energy striking on the surface of the metal can be calculated with the help of lambda value. Lambda value is given as 300 nanometers. Then, what is the minimum energy needed? What is the minimum energy needed to remove the electron? Minimum energy needed means what should be calculated? E naught value should be calculated. So in this problem, first we are going to calculate the total energy of the 1 mole of ejected electrons. From that one, we are going to calculate E naught value. E naught means, what is meant by E naught? Minimum energy needed to remove the electrons of 1 mole. After that, we are going to calculate minimum energy needed to remove 1 electron. So this is the problem given. And from this total data, we are going to do the calculations with the help of the formula. E, capital E is equal to E naught plus KE. The formula, capital E is equal to E naught plus KE. Right, first I am writing the formula. So the formula is capital E is equal to S. Capital E is equal to E naught plus KE. This is the formula regarding of photoelectric effect. First, I am going to calculate the capital E value. Capital E means the amount of energy striking on the surface of the metal, capital E value. Capital E formula, capital E is equal to Hc by lambda. H value is known. What is the H value? 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34. Joules second. Joules second. 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules second into C value, velocity of light. Velocity of light is 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meters per second by lambda value. How much lambda is given? 300 nanometers is given. Nanometers means 10 power minus 9 meters. So here I am taking the values in terms of SI units. In the physics you studied, the units are of two types, CGS units and SI units. In general, we are using SI units. So here H value is taken 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules second. Joules second is the unit of SI unit into C value. C means velocity of light, speed of light. 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meters per second. Meters per second is also the SI unit. By lambda value. Lambda value is 300 nanometers is given. 1 nanometer is equal to 10 to the power of minus 9 meters. Meter is also the SI unit. So all the values must be taken in the SI units only. Then only the calculation is correct. So whenever any one of the values is given in the CGS unit, other the values are given in the SI units, we should convert all the values into one type of units. Whether it may be into CGS units or it may be into SI units. Here I am taking the SI units values. So what I am going to calculate is total energy of the radiation striking on the surface of the metal having a wavelength of 300 nanometers. Then capital E is equal to, capital E is equal to how much value? Capital E is equal to how much? So for simplicity, already I have done this problem. For your convenience, just simply I am going to share the calculations to avoid the wastage of the time. So on the screen, once you can see the same problem. So first of all, I am taking the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is given in the problem. How much kinetic energy is given? Kinetic energy is given in the problem as 1.68 into 10 to the power of 5 joules per mole. So that was the first line. Kinetic energy of the ejected electrons KE is equal to 1.68 into 10 to the power of 5 joules per mole. This was given in the problem. How many moles of electrons are ejected? 1 mole of electrons are ejected. They are having the kinetic energy 1.68 into 10 to the power of 5 joules. And the electrons ejected are having wavelength. How much wavelength? The wavelength of emitted radiations. The wavelength of emitted radiation. Whether it is emitted radiation or striking radiation. My dear students, it is not the emitted radiation. Here is the correction. Just a minute, I will correct it. Give me a minute. Yes. Here it is, not emitted radiations. What you have to write? Wavelength of the radiations striking on the surface of the metal. Wavelength of radiations striking. Wavelength of radiations striking or hitting. Wavelength of radiations striking on the surface of the metal. The wavelength is given as 300 nanometers. Right? Okay, fine. Now, H value means Planck's constant value. Planck's constant value is given as, it is a constant value. What is the value? 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules a second. And C means velocity of light or speed of light. Speed of light is known. 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meters per second. And we know the Avogadro number. Avogadro number capital N is equal to 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. So all these values are known values. So with the help of these known values, we are going to calculate energy of 1 mole of photons emitted. Energy required to eject 1 mole of electrons. That is the energy of 1 mole of photons emitted. Capital E is equal to capital N into h nu. Here capital N means Avogadro number. Small h means Planck's constant value. Instead of nu, what I am taking is C by lambda. So all these values are substituted here. Yes, this is the substitution. Energy of 1 mole of electrons should be emitted. That is the energy of 1 mole of photons, which is going to be striking on the surface of the metal. Capital E is equal to 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. That is the 1 mole Avogadro number into Planck's constant. 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 into C by lambda. Once again, see the formula. What is the formula given? Capital N into H into C by lambda. So C value. What is the C value? 3 into 10 to the power of 8 meters per second by lambda value. 300 into 10 to the power of minus 9. So if you do the calculation here, you will get the answer 39.90 into 10 to the power of 4 joules per mole. So to eject 1 mole of electrons, when the 300 nanometers of wavelength containing radiation is going to strike, that radiation is having how much energy means? The radiation is going to have the energy 3.99 into 10 to the power of 5 joules per mole. So this is the energy. Yes. See the board. Capital E value. H C by lambda. H value is 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34. C value. 3 into 10 to the power of 8 by lambda value. 300 into 10 to the power of minus 9. Because here it is 300 nanometers. Instead of nanometer, I am writing 10 power minus 9. So what is the E value calculated? Just a minute. Yes, the E value calculated as 3.99 into 10 to the power of 5 joules per mole. 10 to the power of 5 joules per mole. Here, what the meaning it is? Capital E is indicating energy required to eject 1 mole of electrons. Energy required to eject 1 mole of electrons. Here I am writing the statement. Energy required to eject or to remove. Energy required to eject 1 mole of electrons. 1 mole of electrons is equal to, that is capital E is equal to 3.99 into 10 to the power of 5 joules. Yes, you will get that doubt again. Sir, here E value is written as 3.99 into 10 to the power of 5 joules per mole. But here the E value is written as 3.99 into 10 to the power of 5 joules only. Why? Because means here already I am mentioning the energy required to eject 1 mole of electrons. Hence, here no need to write again per mole. Okay? So that is the E value calculated, capital E value calculated. And we know the kinetic energy. The kinetic energy of ejected 1 mole electrons. How much value is given? The kinetic energy of ejected electrons. In the problem, it was given. What is the kinetic energy of ejected electrons? See here, the kinetic energy of ejected electrons is given as 1.68 into 10 to the power of 5 joules. So in the problem, K is given, and from the problem we are calculating the capital E value. Then we can calculate what we can calculate E naught value, because we know the formula, capital E is equal to E naught plus KE. Capital E is equal to E naught plus KE. Here you know the E value, and we know the KE value. Then we can calculate E naught value. What is meant by E naught? E naught means threshold energy. Threshold energy means the minimum amount of energy of radiation required to eject an electron from the surface of the metal. That is the E naught value. E naught is equal to E minus KE. Now substitute the E value. So E naught is equal to capital E. How much value is obtained? Capital E value. The capital E is obtained as 3.99. Capital E value is 3.99 into 10 to the power of 5 joules per mole minus. That is the capital E value. And KE value. KE value is given in the problem. How much KE value is given? The KE value is given in the problem as 1.68 into 10 to the power of 5 joules per mole. So this is the value given in the problem. And this was the value calculated from the given data. Then we can calculate E naught value. Yes, tell me the E naught value. What is the E naught value? 3.99 minus 1.68. 9 minus 8. 9 minus 6. 3 minus 1. So E naught value is equal to 2.31 into 10 to the power of 5 joules per mole. So this is the E naught value. What is meant by E naught? E naught means threshold energy. Threshold energy of 1 mole of electrons is calculated. Now we have to calculate the minimum amount of energy required to eject 1 electron. But here we calculated the minimum amount of energy required to eject 1 mole of electrons is calculated. We can calculate the minimum amount of energy required to eject 1 electron. How can we calculate? If this value is divided with 1 mole is nothing but Avogadro number, 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. If this value is divided with Avogadro number, then we will get the minimum amount of energy required to eject 1 electron. So here I'm calculating the minimum amount of energy required. To eject one electron. How much amount of energy is required? That is E naught is equal to, already we obtained the value. How much value is obtained? Text me the answer. E naught value, how much is obtained? That's 2.31 into 10 to the power of 5 joules per mole. per mole means by mole. Mole is equal to 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. Here the unit is joules. So this is the minimum amount of energy required to eject one electron. Yes. Please make the calculation and tell me the answer. E naught is equal to how much? Here we are calculating the E naught. That E naught indicates the minimum amount of energy required to eject one electron. The minimum amount of energy required to eject one electron. The minimum amount of energy required to eject one electron is equal to 2.31 into 10 to the power of 5 by Avogadro number. On the screen, you are seeing the calculation. On the screen, you are seeing the same calculation. 2.31 into 10 to the power of 5 by NA. N means a number. A means Avogadro. So to represent the Avogadro number, we can write the symbol NA. So then the calculation, 2.31 into 10 to the power of 5 by 6.023 into 10 to the power of 23. The calculation is 0.3835 into 10 to the power of minus 18 joules. So how much amount of energy is required to eject an electron? The minimum amount of energy required to eject one electron, not to eject one mole of electrons. To eject one mole of electrons, the energy required is 2.31 into 10 to the power of 5 joules. But to eject one electron, the energy required to eject one mole of electrons divided with one mole, then we are getting the minimum amount of energy required to eject one electron. That is 0.3835 into 10 to the power of minus 18. Right. If this decimal is moved to right side, if the decimal is moved to right side one time, then we will write the answer. E naught is equal to 3.835 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. So this is our answer. The minimum amount of energy required to eject one electron from the surface of the sodium metal when the sodium metal is going to be striked with 300 nanometers of wavelength. So what is the minimum energy required to eject one electron is 3.835 into 10 to the power of minus 19. And all of you know about these numbers. After decimal, if more than 5 is there, so the before value, 1 must be added. 1 must be added. So here 5 is there more than, or 5 or more than 5 is there. So the before value, 1 is added. Then we can write the answer as E naught is equal to 3.84 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. This is our answer. Yes, once again, I'm going to show you the problem. What is asked in the problem? Yes, on the screen, you can see, you can read the problem once again. Here, I'm starting from here. What is the minimum energy needed to remove an electron? An electron means only one electron. But initially, we calculated the minimum amount of energy required to eject one mole of electrons. Text me the answer. How much energy is required to eject one mole of electrons in this problem? In this problem, how much energy is required to eject one mole of electrons? How much energy is required to eject one mole of electrons? On the board, the answer is also there. To eject one mole of electrons, how much energy is required? Correct. 2.31 into 10 to the power of 5 joules energy is required. Correct. Once again, to eject one mole of electrons, the energy required is 2.31 into 10 to the power of 5 joules. Okay, fine. To eject one electron, that obtained value is divided with Avogadro number. See here, this is the obtained value, 2.31 into 10 to the power of 5. Wait a minute. Yes, this is the obtained value, 2.31 into 10 to the power of 5. This is the amount of energy required to eject one mole of electrons. That is divided with Avogadro number. Then we are getting the value, the minimum amount of energy required to eject
an electron or one electron. Now the answer is, this is our answer, 3.84 into 10 to the power of minus 19 joules. Yes. What is calculated here? What is calculated? E naught is calculated. And again, from the Planck's quantum theory, E is equal to, capital E is equal to hc by lambda. Capital E is equal to hc by lambda. Then we can write E naught is equal to, just tell me, E naught is equal to, h is a constant value, c is a constant value, lambda is a variable which get changes, is called as variable. Lambda is a variable value. Then I can write the formula, E naught is equal to hc by lambda naught. Now, if you see the problem again, if you read the problem again, one more is asked in the problem. We have to calculate one more. What we have to calculate? Yes. Now you can read the continuation part. See this one. What is the maximum wavelength that will cause? My dear student, see here. What is the maximum wavelength? Not the minimum wavelength. What is the maximum wavelength that will cause a photoelectron to be emitted? We have to understand this one. What is the maximum wavelength that will cause photoelectron to be emitted? We have to calculate the maximum wavelength. Maximum wavelength. Wavelength is represented by, the wavelength is represented by lambda. We have to calculate the maximum wavelength from the E naught value. What is E naught? What is meant by E naught? The minimum amount of energy required to eject an electron. Yes, threshold energy, correct. The minimum amount of energy. Here, energy and lambda, energy and wavelength are inversely proportional. Once again, energy and wavelength are inversely proportional. I'm writing the formula here. Energy and wavelength are inversely proportional. Whenever minimum amount of energy is there, maximum wavelength should be calculated, because energy is inversely proportional to wavelength. So from this formula, E naught is equal to hc by lambda naught. E naught is equal to hc by lambda naught. We are going to calculate the lambda naught. Lambda naught means, what is meant by lambda naught? Lambda naught means maximum wavelength of radiation. Maximum wavelength of radiation required to eject an electron. This should be calculated. Yes, we are going to calculate this one. Lambda naught is equal to hc by E naught. H value, 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 joules second into C value, 3 into 10 to the power of 8 by E naught value. Yes, now we will get it out. E naught value. What should be the E naught value here? We are having two types of E naught values. What we have to take here? Let's text me your answer. What would be the E naught value should be taken here? Whether it is 2.1 into 10 to the power of 5, whether it is 2.31 into 10 to the power of 5, or 3.84. Yes, 3.84. Because we are calculating the lambda naught value for one electron. As a result, in this calculation, here E naught value is, it is not 3.84. My dear students, sorry, it is not 2 point. What is the value? Just a minute. Yes, what should be the value? 2.31 is the 1 mole of energy. Here 3.835 into 10 to the power of minus 19 per joules. 19 joules is the energy required to eject one electron. So E naught should be 3.84 into 10 to the power of minus 19. So don't get confused here. 3.84 into 10 to the power of minus 19. Most of the students are doing the mistakes at this step only. At this step only. Because here we are calculating the lambda naught for one electron. Lambda naught for one mole of electrons. If it is the lambda naught for one mole of electrons, here it should not be the 3.84 into 10 to the power of minus 19. Anyhow, we are calculating the lambda naught for one electron. What is the value? Yes, here is the calculation. You can see the calculation. Because during the online, it is not easy to do the calculations. Because the time is going to be wasted. That's why I already completed the calculation on the screen. You can see the calculation. Lambda naught is equal to Hc by E naught. H value 6.6256 into 10 to the power of minus 34 into C value 3 into 10 to the power of 8 by lambda naught, E naught value 3.84 into 10 to the power of minus 19. So finally, after calculation, we are getting the value, this value 5.1762. The lambda naught value is equal to 5.1762 into 10 to the power of minus 7 meters. Yes, coming to the board. So finally, if we calculate this one, we are getting the lambda naught value as 5.1762 into 10 to the power of minus 7. Okay, I am going to move this decimal again to the right side two times. This decimal is moving one time and second time, then I will get the answer 517.62 into 10 to the power of minus 9 meters. Yes, you can see this value. 10 to the power of minus 9 meters means nanometer. 10 to the power of minus 9 meters means nanometer. Then I can write lambda naught is equal to 517 nanometers. I am neglecting these values. Decimal values I am going to neglect. So simply I can write lambda naught is equal to 517 nanometers. Lambda naught is the 517 nanometers. Yes, on the screen you can see now. This is about a visible spectrum. All of you know the visible spectrum. The visible spectrum is ranging between 400 nanometers to 750 nanometers. Already it was discussed in the electromagnetic spectrum. During the discussion of electromagnetic spectrum, gamma rays, X-rays, UV rays, visible rays, microwaves, infrared rays, radio waves, all those was discussed in electromagnetic spectrum. One of the part of electromagnetic spectrum is a visible spectrum, that is nothing but WIPZR. So the WIPZR is ranging between 400 nanometers to, see here, wavelength is given. The wavelength is given in the nanometers, 400 nanometers to 750 nanometers. And we are obtained the lambda naught. Maximum wavelength of radiation is obtained. That value is obtained as 517 nanometers. So this 517 nanometers corresponds to green light. See the statement? The 517 nanometers of wavelength of radiation corresponds to green light. So to understand this point, I am showing you the visible spectrum. This is the visible spectrum. 400 nanometers, 500 nanometers, 600 nanometers. Between 500 nanometers and 600 nanometers, suppose if I am taking here, that is the 517 nanometers. What is the color? See, this is the color. Green light color. So when 300 nanometers of wavelength of radiation is going to strike the sodium metal, one mole of electrons are going to be ejected. To eject one electron, the maximum wavelength of radiation required is, which type of light is required? Green color light is required. And its wavelength is 517 nanometers. So this is all about
problem based on photoelectric effect. Still one more problem is there. We will discuss in the next class. If you understood the class, text me in the chat box. Lakshmi Kalburgi, yes, very fast response. I will share the PDF. Once check the PDF also. I will share the PDF and I will send the recorded version. If you are unable to understand in the live, once go through the recorded version. Still, if you are having any doubt, please call me between 7 p.m. to 8 p.m. only and don't text. And while you are texting to your lecturers, have some respect, give some respect. Give respect and take respect. Yes, text me your response in the chat box. Whether the class is understood or not. Whether I have to revise it or not. Please text. Don't text S. Understood or not? Yes, thank you one and all. Have a nice day.